13:5-11. Jesus said to them, "Watch out so that no one deceives you. Many will come in my name, claiming I'm he, and will deceive many. When you hear of wars and rumors of war, do not be alarmed. Such things must happen, but the end is still to come. Nation will rise up against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be earthquakes in various places and famines. These are the beginning of birth pains. You must be on your guard. You will be handed over to the local councils and flogged in the synagogue. On account of me, you will stand before governors and kings as witnesses to them. And the gospel must first be preached to all nations. Whenever you're arrested and brought to trial, do not worry beforehand about what to say. Just say whatever is given to you at the time, for it is not you speaking, but the Holy Spirit." Luther's efforts to tell others about Jesus called a multinational uproar, and it led him to experience the fulfillment of Jesus' prophecy, "On account of me, you'll stand before governors and kings." How'd that happen? Remember, he spoke of the teaching that proclaims that almost all believers, after they die, must go to a place called purgatory until they achieve the holiness necessary to enter heaven. Note the word almost. The Roman teaching also states that there have been a few people, saints such as Mary and apostles like Peter and Paul, who did more good works than they needed for their own salvation to get into heaven. What's more, they said Jesus has an endless surplus of good works and is called by the church leaders the treasury of Mary. The church, especially the leaders and the Pope, could dip into this treasury and transfer those good works to those who didn't have enough good works. And they call this transfer of good works an indulgence, a pardon. Those who purchased indulgence no longer had to make up for their sins. They could have their time in purgatory reduced. Church leaders saw that this could be a great way to raise funds for their project. During the time of Luther, it was Pope Leo X was Pope, and he had a great big building project. He was building the huge and magnificent cathedral or Basilica of St. Peter. It is magnificent. It still stands today. Leo, however, didn't have enough money to do it. And then he or one of his cardinals or someone came up with the idea to raise money by issuing an indulgence called a plenary, which means covering all sins, indulgence. And Leo then sent men out to sell it. One of the men was a Dominican monk named John Tetzel. In an area near Wittenberg, Tetzel sold the following indulgence: "May our Lord Jesus Christ have mercy on thee and absolve thee by the merits of his most holy passion, and I by his authority, that of his blessed apostles Peter and Paul, and of the most holy Pope, granted and committed to me in these parts, do absolve thee first from the all ecclesiastical censures, in whatever manner they may have been incurred, and then from all thy sins, transgressions, and excesses, how enormous so they ever may be, even from such as reserved for the cognizance of the Holy See. And as far as the keys of the Holy Church extend, I remit to you all punishment which you deserve in purgatory on their account, and I restore to you the holy sacraments of the Church, and to that innocence and purity which you possessed at baptism, so that when you die, the gates of punishment shall be shut, and the gates of paradise of delight shall be opened. And if you shall not die at present, this grace shall remain in full force when you are at the point of death, in the name of the Father, Son, and of the Holy Ghost." Now that's rather difficult to understand, isn't it? And the common people, they would have went, "What?" So Tetzel and the other salesmen, they simplified it. They used the following jingle: "As soon as the coin in the coffer rings, a soul out of purgatory springs." Tetzel's claim got to Luther's ears, and it upset Luther because he knew, he believed God's word, that salvation comes only through repentance, through confessing your sins and trusting that Jesus redeemed you through his innocent suffering and death and his holy precious blood. It can't be bought with silver or gold. Then God moved Luther to be more than just upset. He moved Luther to action. On October 31st, 1517, Luther posted 95 theses in Latin on the door to the Catholic Church in Wittenberg. Luther's plan was to have a scholarly debate over the indulgences and the issues there. God's plan was different than Luther's plan. God moved men to translate those theses into a German and print and distribute them throughout Europe. And eventually, these 95 theses found their way to Pope Leo. Leo was worried that the sale of indulgences would fall off. His project would stop if this went on. So he sent Cardinal Cajetan to demand that Luther withdraw all his writing, while Luther refused. Later on, in a debate with a German scholar named Dr. Eck, Luther said that it was not necessary to obey the Pope in order to be saved. Well, when the Pope heard that, he issued a bull, which is an official proclamation declaring Luther a heretic. However, the bull didn't work. Luther continued to write, printers continued to publish his writing, people continued to come to faith in Jesus. And this whole thing threatened the whole political system. Remember, the Pope claimed that, and many believe that their governors, their kings and princes and emperors got their power from God through the Pope. So the emperor at that time, Charles V, he summoned Luther to a meeting called the Diet of Worms. And the emperor was there, many princes and many church officials, all the powers of the world were there. They demanded that Luther recant. Luther take back all of his writings. But they were going to declare him an outlaw who would be subject to be captured, and if captured, be tortured, and then be burned at the stake. Now Luther refused. And he proclaimed Christ with one of the most famous Christian confessions of all history. He stood up and he said, "Unless I am convinced by the testimonies of the Holy Scriptures or evident reason, I am neither able or willing to recant, since it is neither safe nor right to act against conscience. Here I stand. I cannot do otherwise. God help me. Amen." Luther stood before governors and kings, as Jesus said his followers would.